In sports, the clock is ticking towards the 14th World Championships in Moscow. Africans will be looking to garner an impressive medal haul in the middle and long distances. But short distance could be a struggle, and one of Africa's few sprint champions is blaming neglect. This report from CCTV Celestine Karone.
Very few athletes from Africa can boast a world or Olympic medal in the sprint. Samuel Mateta from Zambia is among that elite club. In 1991, he won Zambia's first world title in athletics. But 22 years on, Zambia can barely put together a team for a world championship.
And currently, we don't have anyone from Zambia who is going to really go to the world championship and make an impact. We just have local athletes who are pretty much not even at performance level.
So where did Zambia go wrong? Like many African countries, in Zambia, financing sport is a challenge. Previously, athletes like Matete would go abroad in search of good facilities. Today, many African countries have built state-of-the-art stadiums, but sprinters remain in short supply.
But the challenge we have is, do we know how to utilize these facilities and get the best out of Africa? Because Africa still has a lot of raw talent.
Still, Africa does have some short-distance contenders in Moscow. 100-meter athletes Nigeria's Blessing Okagbare and Muriel Ahore of Cote d'Ivoire, alongside 400-meter world champion Amantle Monsho of Botswana, are the sprinters to watch.
Yes, Okagbare has actually been establishing herself very, very well. Last year, you know, she really came close to getting it, you know. But the most important thing is, the most important thing at that level is consistency. Yeah? And I think Okagbare has achieved that. Mantla could have won a medal last year, could have won a gold medal, but she did not go in the games with that mind. But I'm sure those are the kind of things that make an athlete becomes even more wanting to do, you know, better.
Matete also won a Commonwealth title as well as Olympic silver during his career. He wants to go into administration of athletics in Zambia to try lift the sport's fortunes. In Zambia, football is a sport of choice for many, with the 2012 Africa Cup of Nations win still fresh in people's minds. Athletics is trying to emerge from this shadow, but lack of talent development means the gap between Matete's generation and the next Zambia sprints medalist continues to widen. Celestine Karone, CCTV.
In 2012, Anthony Obame became Gabon's first Olympic medalist with a silver medal in Taekwondo. He followed that Olympic performance with a gold medal in the recently concluded World Championships in Mexico. Our correspondent in Libreville caught up with the athlete, who opened up about how he initially enjoyed basketball at the Olympics but ended up in Taekwondo.
Mon actu c'est mon titre de champion du monde que j'ai eu récemment.
I'm happy to be back home after winning the gold medal in Mexico. I felt like I was avenging the Olympic final loss. During the Olympics, the pressure got to me, and the fear of losing was greater than that of winning then. But during the world final, it was the opposite. I worked on my tactics, and I knew I had it in me to win, so I didn't bother with the result, just got the job done. It was about determination and the motivation to win, as well as the support that I have from all over. When I was young, I always watched the Olympics and mainly basketball. When I took interest in Taekwondo, I promised myself that one day I would compete in the Olympics, and though it took longer than I expected, I'm now the first Olympic medalist for Gabon, and that just shows that if you really want something, you can achieve it.
All right, we'll leave it there for now. Thanks for watching Africa Live. I'm Penina Karibe. I'll join you at 1700 GMT for more.